Let's see how this one goes.
Yeah.
Haven't played it for a while.
Yeah, it's a nice
one. All right.
Thank you.
start. Ready?
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 97th Spring Convocation. The ceremony will begin shortly. At this time, I ask you to please stand for the procession of the graduands. Please be seated. I would ask you to direct your attention to the screens on either side of the stage. We will now be showing our This Is the Moment video, which provides a snapshot of your university experience. We are now at the end of your time with us at Brock, and we look forward to your new role as part of our alumni community.
This is the moment that defines what happens next. This is the moment you knew what you wanted. And this is the moment you got it. This is the moment you said goodbye. And this is the moment you missed. This is the moment the distance was surprisingly short. And this is the moment the distance was painfully long. This is the moment you opened the door to a new house. And this is the moment it became a home. This is the moment you took some notes. This is the moment you took it all in. This is the moment you fell in love. And this is the moment you fell asleep. This is the moment she told you to take a hike. And this is the moment you did. This is the moment you reached for new heights. And this is the moment you reached new land. This is the moment you learned something new. And this is the moment you had to remember it. This is the moment you were overwhelmed. This is the moment you overachieved. This is the moment you stopped. This is the moment you caught your breath. And this is the moment it was taken away. This is the moment you took the night. And this is the moment you took the stage. This is the moment you say you'll never forget. This is the moment they won't let you. This is the moment you wondered how you would do it. This is the moment you realized why you are here. This is your proudest moment. This is their proudest moment. This is the moment you realize the importance of this moment. And this is the moment that defines what happens next.
And this is your moment today. Enjoy every minute. Please remain seated. The faculty procession will begin shortly. Session is about to begin. Please rise at the sounding of the fanfare. Thank you.
Please be seated. I declare the 97th convocation for the conferring of degrees and certificates in session. Acting Chancellor and President Lightstone, Acting Vice Chancellor and Provost Dr. McCartney, Trustee Hurst, Senate Chair Sider, Grand Chief Yesno, platform guests, graduating students, parents, and friends. Welcome to Brock University's Spring Convocation, a time of celebration for our students, families, and friends. It is my pleasure this morning to introduce from the Chancellor's procession, Dr. Jack Lightstone, Acting Chancellor and President of Brock University. Dr. Neil McCartney, Acting Vice Chancellor, Provost and Vice President Academic of Brock University. Ms. Carolyn Hurst, Brock University Board of Trustees. Mr. Brian Hutchings, Vice President, Finance and Administration. Professor Susan Sider, Mace Bearer and Chair of Brock University Senate. Dr. Gary Libin, Vice President, Research. Dr. Greg Finn, Vice Provost and Associate Vice President, Academic. Dr. Anna Lathrop, Vice Provost, Teaching and Learning. Dr. Carol Merriam, Interim Dean, Faculty of Humanities. Ms. Kim Mead, Vice Provost and Associate Vice President, Student Services. Dr. Michael Pliley, Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies. Grand Chief Harvey Yesno, Anishinaabe Aski Nation. Dr. Fiona Blakey, Dean, Faculty of Education. Dr. Jennifer Rousel, Professor and Canada Research Chair in Multiliteracies, and our guests this morning to deliver the convocation address. Joining them on stage are university senators, faculty, staff, and student representatives from across the university. I would ask them to also please stand together and be recognized with their colleagues. Please be seated. I now invite President Lightstone to deliver words of welcome.
Provost McCartney, Trustee Hurst, Chair of Senate Sider, Convocation Speaker Dr. Rousel, Grand Chief Yesno, Dean Blakey, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family of the graduates, welcome. And to you graduates, a very special welcome indeed. On behalf of the Brock community, I would like to begin by acknowledging and honoring the ancestors of those on whose traditional lands we gather today. Brock University is located along what today is known as the Bruce Trail, on the traditional shared territory of the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Attawandaron. Today, we acknowledge the First Nation, Métis, and Inuit peoples and all Indigenous peoples who have joined us for this convocation. Now, graduates, this is your day. How do you feel? Oh, pretty good. Friends and family of the graduates, how do you feel to be here? So, as happy as you graduates may be that you're here today, and perhaps you're relieved as well, from the cheering behind you, I suspect that they are more relieved than you are. And of course, they're very proud of you, as you've just heard, as you should be of yourselves. And you should also know that we, who represent the trustees and Senate and faculty and staff and administration of Brock University, are also very proud of you, and we share in the joy that you feel, and we share in the joy that your family and friends feel, because today represents not only the culmination of your work, but in a very real way, it represents the culmination of our work as well. So we celebrate with you. Now, as you can all see, convocation is an event that is steeped in tradition and ritual and in formalization. After all, the graduates parade in to 18th century music, then the platform party parades in, also to 18th century music, and we, you graduates, and those of us who represent the administration, faculty, and staff of the university, we are all dressed in the height of fashion for the 16th century. But despite the formalism and the ritual and the tradition, I want you all to know that first and foremost, today is a day of celebration. And that means that it's perfectly acceptable, in fact, I encourage it, that family and friends of the graduates hoot and holler and yell and scream and whistle and stamp their feet to celebrate and recognize their friend or loved one as he or she crosses the stage to receive his or her diploma. In order to get everyone in the right mood, we will have a practice run on the count of three. One, two, three. Enjoy convocation.
It is my pleasure to introduce Ms. Carolyn Hurst, member of the Board of Trustees, who will present the Spirit of Brock Medal. Ms. Hurst has served on the board since 2012 and is currently the chair of the board's Strategic Planning Committee. She brings a wealth of business and volunteer experience to the university. She is an accomplished business leader with over 20 years of business transformation consulting and information technology operations management experience. She is the former vice president of Capgemini and is currently an independent consultant. She has a proven track record of identifying and managing risk and delivering superior results in all of these operational roles. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Carolyn Hurst.
Thank you. Dr. Lightstone, honored guests, faculty, staff, and graduates. The Board of Trustees recognizes the commitment, dedication, and sacrifice that it takes to become a graduate of Brock University. We take great pride in your achievements and share with you and your family in the celebration of your success. I don't know if that's the time for the hoot. As a part of this celebration, the Board of Trustees created a unique award in order to pay tribute to the outstanding achievements and contributions of graduating students. During this spring convocation, the Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal will be awarded to undergraduate and graduate students who best exemplify the spirit of Sir Isaac Brock. Students who demonstrate any one or more of the qualities of leadership, courage, innovation, inspiration, and community involvement have been recommended to receive the award by their respective faculty dean. Today, I have the immense honor to present this Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal to Faculty of Education undergraduate student William Morgan. William Morgan exemplifies the spirit of Brock through his leadership, courage, innovation, inspiration, and community involvement. William lost most of his eyesight when he was 10 years old. William has experienced not just the challenges of vision impairment, but also the limitations placed on him. For example, at elementary school, he was not allowed to play sports. In spite of this, William became the first person with visual impairment in Canada to receive a third degree black belt in judo and to become an official coach. Yeah. But William hasn't stopped there. He has volunteered extensively as a community mentor, proving that with courage and with inspiration, achieving goals is possible, such as being a teacher candidate in the Department of Teacher Education, Faculty of Education. Once again, please join me in congratulating William Morgan.
And now I take pleasure in inviting Professor Jennifer Rousel to deliver the convocation address. Professor Rousel.
Thank you very much. Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations, parents. Feel proud of what you have achieved and what your children have achieved, and feel great anticipation. Because there's never been a more vibrant time to be a teacher. For my short speech, I offer you three questions taken from Leo Tolstoy's book, The Three Questions. But I add a twist, and the twist is putting an educator's lens on these questions. The Three Questions is the story about a boy who asks his friends three guiding life questions, and through a series of life experiences and epiphanies, with some help from a sage friend, he finds an answer to each one. So question number one, when is the best time to do things? There's only one time, and that is now. The best time to be a teacher is right now. The landscape of education has shifted dramatically over the past decade, and it is both an exciting and daunting time to be a teacher. Exciting because there are so many ways to learn now, and so many devices and mediums through which to learn. Intimidating because curriculum, pedagogy, and assessment have not kept a pace with these changes, and you'll need to use all of your creativity, your innovation, and your passion to keep kids engaged and motivated. Question number two, who is the most important one? The most important one is always the one you are with. As a teacher, there are two important ones, you and your students. Margaret Mead said 4 decades ago, "We are now at a point when we educate our children in what no one knew yesterday and prepare our schools for what no one knows yet." And that is exactly where your children are. Children today think and learn in vastly different ways. And it's up to you to teach through these new diverse ways and have enough agency yourself as an educator to teach as your conscience and vision dictate. Question number three, what is the right thing to do? That's an easy one. The right thing to do is to do good for the one who is standing at your side. The right thing to do is to love where you are now and exhibit that love in a multitude of ways in your teaching and in your life. Acknowledge what your students love. Minecraft, Instagram, Monster High, Pokemon, Google searches. Whatever it is that they love, love it too. Also, share what you love. To me, the right thing to do as a teacher is not only to get to know who your students are as learners, but also as people. So to conclude this short speech, take stock of these three possible answers to three important guiding life questions And dear graduates, I wish you inspiration in your classrooms and longevity as an educator. Thank you very much.
Will the candidates for the various degrees please rise? With the degrees and certificates about to be conferred upon you, there comes a certain expectation that you will continue sincerely in the pursuit of learning and truth, and that as far as in you lies, you will promote the interests and welfare of your university. Do you acknowledge this expectation?
Yes.
Mr. Chancellor, as the candidates have acknowledged the responsibilities that accompany their degrees, and as they have successfully completed the courses of study prescribed by Senate, I would ask that you admit them to their several degrees and certificates.
It is my pleasure to admit you all. Congratulations. Please be seated.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Education.
Edris Alabaze, Reina Alashmawi. Woo. Kenneth Aldridge, Uzma Alim. Jordan Marie Allum, Jennifer Aruda. Sabrina Arturi, Fatima Atia. Monica Bachavina, Tahira Taslima Bach. Matthew Beaton, Craig Bentham. Cynthia Ann Behringer, Melissa Bishop. Doreen Bonsu, Laura Bottrell. Michael Bozic, Adissa Christina Bozzo. Carly Breda, Mary Jane Leanne Braun. Marissa Brennan, Shanna Brophy. Emily Brown, Sophia Kalenda. Melissa Campbell, Sean Carroll. Adriana Kashusko, Sheila Kashkavar Arshad. Isabella Charalampas, Sean Christie. Sarah Clark, Jacqueline Cobb, recipient of the Russell N. Eden Art Award. Sharon Elizabeth Coleman, Courtney Helen Condi. Stephen Cornacchia, Antonia Catone. Sarah D'Alessio. Donna Delgleish, Sarah Mae Delgleish. Liana Elizabeth DuPont, Peter DeVries. John Carlos Delphin, Christine Louise Dent. Elisa Di Clemente, Melissa Christine DiMaggio. Alexandria Janine Marie DeFazio, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Teacher Education Junior Intermediate and the Dean's Award for Professional Growth Junior Intermediate. Scott Raymond Dobbin. Courtney Dodgen, Isabella DeVecchio. Salima El Haj and Ashley Roach Falcone. Alicia Fanton and Natasha Faria. Alice Franco, Tiffany Garrett. Amanda Garzo, Ali Geddes. Sarah Gomes, Tabitha Gonzalez. Chantel Govia, Vikas Gupta. Samantha Evelyn Haynes, Lubna Habunda. Sarah Hilario, Rebecca Hiltz. Lindsay Huxon, Anita Veronica Islick. Dilveen Esmail, Emil Audrey Jackson. Joelle Jackson, Kayla Emily Jackson. Nicole Jarosowskis, Jordan Jenkins. Brittany Jones, Sarah Jones. Sean Jordan, Suman Joseph. Jade Kolensky, Mary Laycock. Ashley Lake, Anna Maria Lally. Michael Londrio, Brittany Jessica Lawler. Alan Lee, Lucas LeGros. Stefan LeMay, Jordan Lenjosic, recipient of the Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association OECTA Award. Nicole Lynn Link, Drake Livingston. Selena Luenga, Livia Maria Lopresta. Diana Luke, Brittany Joyce Ludwikowski.
It's pronounced line. It's a great line.
Melissa Line, Cassandra Leons. Curtis McLean, Crystal Malley.
Okay.
Laura Alexandra Manfredi, Angelica Margariti. Anissa Marina, Sarah Marshall. Brittany Massey, Ashley Matto. Heather McCarthy, Lindsay Ann McDonald. Brooke McInnes, Caitlin McManus. Daniel Robert McMillan, Alexandria McCallion. Samantha Miranda, Vanessa Mariani. Caitlin Mollenhauer, Michelle Malone. Devin Moravec. William Morgan, recipient of the Faculty of Education, Board of Trustees, Teacher Education, Spirit of Brock Medal. Aaron Murphy, Jennifer Murphy. Ivanka Najee, Kristen Newell. Veronica Navid, Dagmara Nakowski, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Intermediate Senior Technological Education. Anissa Nunez, Colby Ogden. Sina Osen Makanwa, Diana Pinocho. Graham Park, Victoria Quinn Palazza. Mark Andrew Pettinuso, Katie Phillips. Yes. Rebecca Pitilotto, Michael Piche. Tom Policha, Lee Policha. Aaron Potolivo and Vanessa Prosciutto. Katie Prince, Kara Josephine Quinto. Victoria Racco, Megan Rakowski. Lisa Remsar, Jessica Rangar. Catherine Rapach, Elizabeth Elaine Reeves McClash, recipient of the Dean's Award for Professional Growth for Primary Junior. Lorena Risco, Sarah Catherine Robertson. Tyler George Robertson Roper, Diane Rocha. Lawrence Rose, Carolyn Ross. Alexander Rolls, Lena Sahadio. Dana Soroyu, Christy Lee Sove. Candace Schuster, Jesse Schwartz. Danielle Shime, Sarah Satime. Shivani Shah, Melanie Silva. Victoria Silva, Christina Silvestri. Nanveet Singh, Catherine Skiro. Claire Snelling, Brittany Soberjaski. Beth Sousa, Hudson Brooks Sori Quinn. Stephanie Deanne Stemler, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Teacher Education Primary Junior, the Canadian Federation of University Women Award, and the Elementary Teachers Federation of Ontario EFTO Award. Alexandra Stepanek. Melissa Sunderland, Vasiliki Chesandis. Yuri Cesar Varela Malera, Genevieve Claire Vesio. Amrina Visram, recipient of the Science Teacher Association of Ontario Award for Primary Junior, Julie Walker. Kathleen Wazalenki, Sarah Wiebenka. Aaron Williams, Allison Wilson. Dave Wilson, Alexander Windolf. Jennifer Witt, Natalia Wittick. Yeah. Amanda Catherine Wozni, Robert Michael Zakaria. Kaylee Rose Zinga.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Education Aboriginal.
Cindy Anderson, Marlene Laura Anderson. Grace Bluecoat, Jessie Marianne Bottle. Margaret Phyllis Brown, Tora Kakaspin. Loretta Mikanek, Margaret Miles. Kathy Wesley, Judy Winter.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Arts, Honors, and Bachelor of Education.
Hannah Anderson, Colleen Arojo, with first class standing. Brittany Bernard, Michaela Batke. Melissa Bethlehem, first class standing. Jessica Boyne, with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, Geography BA. Jacob Michael Braun, with first class standing. Aaron Barber Brown, with first class standing. Ashley Bruce, Lauren Burke.
Hey, how's it going?
Good.
Good.
Do you want your middle name again? No.
Sure.
David Ian Burnham, Kate Ann Butter. Alicia Marie Carnegie, with first class standing, Samantha Bonnie Cole. Catherine Gemma Danilon, Catherine D'Souza, with first class standing. Kristen Louise Denise, Denise Catherine Densmore with first class standing. Chelsea Ann DeVoe, Paisley Jane Dix. Carissa DeMarco with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, Child and Youth Studies, and the Department of Child and Youth Studies Book Prize for Concurrent Education. Rebecca Dockstater. Melissa Caitlin Duva, Rosaria Durzo with first class standing. Michelle Diziak, Katrine Audrey Ecclestone with first class standing. Megan Elizabeth Ferron, Lisa Marie Fossey. Kayla Jane Fowler, Joshua Fraccioni. Daniel Gaudet, Jacqueline Elizabeth Giles with first class standing. I did, didn't I? Caitlin Elizabeth Grant, Vanessa Greco. Yeah! Carly Green, Brittany Gremmon, Stephanie Guest with first class standing, Stephanie Gumniak with first class standing. Caitlin Elizabeth Hawes, Jessica Kate Horvat with first class standing. Amanda Elizabeth Grace Howes with first class standing. Rebecca Mary Johnson with first class standing. Recipient of the Science Teachers Association of Ontario Award for Junior Intermediate. Maria Uzepchuk with first class standing. Shannon Kernahan with first class standing. Miriam Kuna, Brooke Kostesian with first class standing. Kathleen Margaret Laird with first class standing. Shanice Catherine Ann Lalou.
Angela I. Chen.
Angela I. Chen Liu with first class standing. Erin Kathleen McMillan with first class standing. Fadia Mama with first class standing. Megan Mandula.
Megan Fadia!
Michael Marchione with first class standing. Lindsay Patricia May. Samantha Lillian McDonald with first class standing, Grace Mellenbacher.
Yeah.
Stephanie Meng, Megan Manuk with first class standing. Lauren Meisner, Aliyah Mohammed with first class standing. Monique Mall with first class standing. Erica Joanne Nada. Madison Elizabeth Neat, Chelsea O'Brien with first class standing. Rachel Michelle O'Brien, Catherine Victoria Percival. Mary Perino, Stephanie Petrina with first class standing. Caitlin Price, first class standing. Holly Nicole Rosinski. Sarah Ann Rasmussen with first class standing. Recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, Concurrence for Primary Junior, Victoria Lynn Renton. Adele Christine Regano, Kyle San Martin, first class standing. Amanda Storm Savelli with first class standing. Ashley Maria Schindelheim. Samantha Lee Schmidt with first class standing. Jessica Sevier. Kaylee Joy Sexton with first class standing. Tara Silva. Cameron William Smith with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Concurrent Junior Intermediate and the Distinguished Graduating Student Award Integrated Study for the Arts. Samantha Lee Stenning, first class standing. David Stobie, Tia Sussinyar. Ann Sutherland with first class standing, Jessica Tiramaco. Melanie Jennifer Taconic with first class standing, Caitlin Turnbull. Annie Van, Carrie Lee Summer-Vogan with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for French. Leah Marissa Waldez with first class standing, Brenda Justina Watzes. Carly Jane Watts, first class standing. Dana Christina Wilkinson with first class standing. Jacqueline Marie Warnick with first class standing. Recipient of the Helen G. Mitchell Award, Alexandra Philomena Wright. Sabrina Morgan Yacht with first class standing.
Woo, Sabrina!
Sabrina!
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Physical Education Honors and Bachelor of Education.
Alexandra Bowers with first class standing, Jessa Carbone. Lucas Crichton with first class standing, Caitlin Goodall with first class standing, recipient of the Ontario Secondary School Teachers Federation Award. Deanna Lewis with first class standing, Katie Murphy with first class standing. Jessica Madeline Piva with first class standing, Danielle Elizabeth Robinson with first class standing.
Jeff Saw,
Francis Anthony Sylvester. Lindsay Toddick, Raya Towsley with first class standing, recipient of the Eleanor Shaw Award. Stephen Daniel Van Aken with first class standing.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Science Honors and Bachelor of Education.
Patrick Bellanger with first class standing, Catherine Berkey with first class standing. Hilary Canviet, Kyron Caputo with first class standing. Kristen Laurel Engel with first class standing. Christine Littlefield with first class standing. Alicia Marie Mancuso with first class standing. Lisa Meinke with first class standing. Josie Margaret Mitnowich, Megan Elizabeth Neal. Rebecca Marie Nixon with first class standing. Maria Julia Reverado. Bradley James Robbins with first class standing, recipient of the Science Teachers Association of Ontario Award for Intermediate Senior, Ashley Joan Robinson.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Early Childhood Education Honors.
Reza Marie Beloy, Spencer Capa Lozano, with first class standing. Sabina Kasson, with first class standing. Leah Cuff, with first class standing. Emily Hudson with first class standing, Corey Job with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, Early Childhood Education. Leah Knight with first class standing, Jennifer Kubina. Colleen Magic with first class standing, Jessica Mullen. Patricia Vucha with first class standing, Elizabeth Wagger. Kylie Wilkes.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Education, Aboriginal Adult Education.
Cynthia Hoy, Jocelyn Jennifer Jameson. Margaret Lynn Key.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Education, Adult Education.
David James Allen, Laura Maria Amodio with distinction. Megan Aaron Banner, Judith Ann Cameron with distinction. Nadine Shaltalal with distinction, Mary Louise Collier with distinction. LaSalle's Lloyd Crawford, Mara Echevez. Pakenham L. Alfrey, Jason Ellis with distinction. Lori Frances Ferrant with distinction, Catherine Fitzmaurice. Wanda Gilmore, Dawn Graham with distinction. Anthony William Harvey, Kenneth Donald Hoover with distinction. David Hurst with distinction, Jacqueline Dawn Hutchison. Bruce Gordon Jackson, Linda Rose Kalmakov with distinction. Tarek Musa Kaun with distinction, Daniela Khan with distinction. Anumi Kim with distinction, Jessica Sandra Michelle Kampf. Matthew. Mathieu Leclerc with distinction, Eva Lamac with distinction. Caitlin Ann Little, Deborah Ann Long. Elizabeth Mayola, Ragida Mazawi with distinction. Carolyn McIsaac, Wendy Irene Murphy with distinction. Sherry Ogden, Elsa Orecchio with distinction. Heather Richardson with distinction, Doreen Elizabeth Ridley with distinction. Paul Ridley, Carolyn Elizabeth Romero with distinction. Alana Sarek, Lynn Ann Schneider with distinction. Kay Shaw, Lori Ann Taylor with distinction. Marion Vanderwood with distinction. Winifred Nadine White with distinction. Brenda Wilfer, Tracy Annalise Williams Wright with distinction.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a certificate in adult education.
Melissa Kong Vong Say, Valerie K. Sprenger.
Thank you.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a certificate in education technological studies.
Andrew Da Camara, Melissa Da Silva. Rob Michael Gendron, Richard Guy. Tamara Harmer, Daniel Hutchison. Jeremy Hynek, Blair Jeffrey Kempers. Michael John Krasny, Michaela Lamenta. Gaston Letourneau, Jamie Levely. Yeah. Ellen Marie Loftus, Bruno Lopez. Angela Mancini, Claudio Marchese. Crystal Lace Mello Sarasa, Dino Nardangeli. Justin Nethercott, Derek Souza. Amanda Spears, Sean Starchuk. Melissa Thompson.
Mr. Chancellor, whereas certain candidates who have successfully completed the course of studies prescribed by Senate are absent from this convocation for just cause, I request that you confer upon them their degrees in absentia.
It is my pleasure to admit them in absentia.
The Senate of Brock University has recommended awarding of a Dean's Medal to the graduate in each faculty with the highest standing in a first class, in a first honors degree, and highest standing in a first pass degree. I take great pleasure in inviting Carissa DiMarco and Cameron William Smith to receive these medals.
I'm very pleased to congratulate all of you who received your degree this morning, as well as all the families and friends in the audience who are bursting with pride at your achievements. As the president of the Brock Alumni Association, I welcome all of you as new alumni of Brock and as new members of our Alumni Association. Congratulations. What does it mean to be an alumni? As of today, you join a membership closing into 90,000 other graduates, alumni who are willing to connect with you, who are willing to work with you, mentor you, and advocate for you in your personal growth and professional development. The value of your degree is a reflection of the success all of our alumni have in their careers and in their personal lives. 86,000 plus alumni that are making their positive marks on the world, having an impact, and the impact raises the value of your degree. But the value of your degree is a reflection of what happens here at Brock long after you're gone. The quality of the programs, the research, the teaching, all intertwine to raise the reputation of Brock and thereby your degree. The reputation of the university is an important stake and one that we hope you take seriously. As you start this new chapter in your lives, see yourselves as ambassadors of your university. Share your Brock experience with others and be sure to share your successes with us. Stay connected to Brock and your alumni association. You can email us, call us, tweet us, Facebook us, join our LinkedIn group, subscribe to our alumni publications, attend homecoming, reunions, and other alumni events. Be in touch with us often, and be as proud of your university as we are of you. Take what you've learned at Brock, go out into the world, and improve it, push on, and experience your life to the fullest. Sergite.
Well, we've come to the end of convocation. How does it feel to have graduated? Are you woken up since the beginning? Family and friends, how does it feel to have seen them graduate? Well, as you've just heard from the representative of the Alumni Association, you graduates are now all alumni of Brock University. And I want to let you know, if you don't realize this, that this is a club from which you can never resign. And you've also heard something about the exhortation from the Alumni Association to remain connected with the university. And what I like to say, in one of my favorite movies from many years ago, is the movie Cool Hand Luke with Paul Newman. Anybody remember that movie? Good. A few. Next, I'll tell jokes from Marx Brothers movies and see how many people remember those. But in Cool Hand Luke, the prison warden in which Luke is imprisoned, and by the way, the prison warden bears no resemblance to me whatsoever, says to Luke, he says, you and I have a symbiotic relationship. Well, you graduates and Brock University have a lifelong symbiotic relationship because the value of your degree is not a fixed entity. That value can go up or down. And it goes up or down depending on two things. It depends on our reputation. In other words, as our university goes from strength to strength and our reputation increases, the value of your degree increases with it. And as you in your lives strive for success after success and become known as successful Brock grads, then you add value to the degrees of students who will graduate years from now. So, stay in touch with us and cherish us and stay engaged. And you should know that if you do not stay in touch with us, we will stay in touch with you. We wish you all success and happiness every day in every year that follows this day of graduation. So once again, from all of us at Brock, congratulations. In a moment, we will rise to sing our national anthem, and after that, first the platform party, and then the graduates will recess in procession from the hall, back to our ritual. And I will ask everyone else, all the family and friends and guests, to please remain seated until that has happened. And then everyone is invited to a reception outside this building to my right, to your left. You will find a tent with refreshments, and there you can meet up with your friends and loved ones and your faculty in order to talk and to reminisce and to have a snack and to wet your whistle. And so, is that a new expression to anyone? All right, thank you. And now please rise for the singing of our national anthem. I declare this convocation dismissed.